a fairly short video, but I'm just basically opening some mail, and then I hop in the Quantum Forefront and go running around in some interesting terrain. And I was actually pleasantly surprised with how well that chair can handle grass and dirt and mud and stuff like that. So there's timestamps down in the description if you want to skip around the video, and also there's a new chapters feature that YouTube has. I've been using it for the last few videos. If you look at the bottom of the player, if you're using a mobile device, you'll see there's little blocks, and you can click on each one to skip through different parts of the video, and they're all labeled. I think that's kind of a cool addition, because a lot of the stuff I do is all over the place, and if you want to skip around, easy to do. I ended up at a friend's place a few days ago. We were basically meeting there before this event that was going on, and we kind of had a little bonfire and a barbecue and everything. And I want to iterate, this is by no means a political video. I'm not expressing any comments or my take on anything that's going on right now. There just happened to be some things going on in the background, and I decided to keep it in the video just to show that, yes, there are things going on everywhere right now. It doesn't matter where you are. It doesn't matter how far out in the middle of nowhere you are. There's things happening that are affecting everyone on planet Earth. A number of things. But anyways, I just wanted to say I'm not making any comment on anything. I'm not saying anything is right or wrong. And unfortunately, disclaimers like this are sort of necessary. This is not what I do on this channel. I don't talk about things like this. But you will see that there are in fact things going on. Yeah, just keep that in mind.
Okay, this is gonna be an impromptu unboxing here. All the protesting seems to have cleared up, so yeah.
We're not immune from anything around here. So is it considered peaceful when you're walking down the middle of the street and there's police helicopters escorting you? Actually, yeah, a plume of smoke might not be the best thing right now. Apparently we're close enough to things here. I think the fire truck's unrelated, but there was police helicopters going over a few minutes ago, and we got a bunch of people marching. And a lot of horns being honked. Got a couple of random packages here. Actually, I know what this one is, so we won't open that. Oh wait, this doesn't need a knife. Let's see what we got. Wait, where'd it come from? Location, shelf. Ooh, coffee. Ah, sweet. Pre-ground for ease of making coffee. Can't smell it. Probably too much beef on my hands from the barbecue earlier. Yes, thank you for the coffee. I think, I'm pretty sure someone sent this kind before. And if I recall, oh wait, there's a note in here. If I recall, it's pretty good. Okay, sweet. More coffee is always good. The other box I got, I kind of filmed unboxing a little bit of that with my phone, so we'll just insert that footage here. This is one of those things that I'm not sure if you're supposed to use a metal knife when you open it or not. I know exactly what this is. And, well, you'll see here in a minute why I'm skeptical. Carefuling. Ooh, it's a loot crate. Oh, did you see this? What? There's a micro drone. Sweet. Oh, it's one of those FPV ones. No way.
Hmm. Well, that's awesome.
Well, he wasn't kidding. And he said he was going to send a bunch of stuff. Wait, what else is in here? Oh, there's two mini drones. Oh, sweet. I was missing the controller, but that's no big deal. Oh, these are awesome. Oh, those motors. Look at the cogging. Maybe that's just the wire. Yeah, there's... Oh, no, it's still got some pretty good magnets in there. Sweet. We got a... Oh, there's a third one.
Third mini drone?
Yeah. Oh, and a multi-charger for drone batteries? Oh, wait. That's housing. There's another one down here. Okay. FPV drone racing it is. We got the cameras and everything. Is it carbon fiber? Yeah.
Hey.
How's it going? We got all kinds of cool stuff in here. All right. This one seems to have some
communication inside of it.
Let's see here. Come out of there, you. It's a note. 6220. Thank you for being you. I appreciate your help. Ah, sweet. No problem, man.
So there's all these mini drones. See, this is great because, like, there's all this stuff that I've wanted to play around with. Like, I've got some random flight controllers laying around, but, like, I don't know. I never actually pull the trigger and buy stuff. So that's awesome. It gives me some projects to work on. Oh, and there's a rock. Utah. Nice. Oh my gosh. These are worth their weight in gold. Holy cow. Thank you. Awesome. Oh, there's our LED tape. Oh, and there's all the mini drone batteries.
Really?
There's like 20 of them in here.
Okay, this is gonna be Quantum Forefront on some uneven terrain. Dirt, grass, a little bit of mud. As you can see, I've been doing some running around already. The fender design is pretty lackluster, so your motors and stuff are gonna get a bunch of garbage on them, but the traction seems to work pretty good, and the suspension as well. I'm gonna be railing on this thing for the next month or so to try and see basically a shakedown to see if there's gonna be any other problems with it and try to get them all addressed. But to be honest, I've been pretty impressed. All this dirt and, like, this is loose dirt here, a bunch of pine cones, like molehills, grass, all kinds of stuff. It seems to do really well. I've been shocked. Even getting up little hills like this, it's kind of hard to tell, but it's mud with a bunch of grass, and I haven't spun out here, or the tires haven't spun. It seems to hold traction just fine, and I can climb right up it. By the way, all that rattling is my keys. Now, granted, you still have to be really careful when you're coming up slippery stuff like this, because if you just keep the throttle hammered down, your tires will start spinning. But as long as you get up a little bit of speed and then let off the throttle as you go up the hill, it does amazingly well. I really need to do something about the lack of fenders, though. All of the garbage that comes off the tires just basically gets splatted right onto the motors and the suspension and everything. So we're gonna have to do some fender mods on this thing. But I've been very impressed with the off-road capability of this thing and how good the ride is. I mean, let me go back here. I'll go back here and show you what the terrain actually looks like. So this is just grass. This has been driven on quite a bit, so it's fairly hard packed. But when we get back here under the trees, you'll see there's a lot of pine cones and sticks and other random pieces of wood and debris. Now this I should probably be careful. We'll try going straight through it. Oh wow, no problem. This is soft too. Yeah, look at the ruts I was leaving in this. That is really soft. Well, I must say, I am impressed. All right, we're gonna run through this one more time, and I'm gonna put the motor, and I'm gonna put the camera down by the motors so you can hear what they sound like.
It's kind of weird. I wasn't quite sure if the forefront was going to be, I don't know, any good off-road at all, but it actually did fairly well. I mean, off-road, it was sort of like cutting through the forest and, you know, going over some grass and other stuff, but I was pleasantly surprised with the suspension. It didn't make a lot of noise other than my keys jingling that were hanging on the front of the chair. It's been sitting here charging, and I think it is time to get this thing cleaned off. Before I got back in the van that evening, I sort of hosed the chair off. And by sort of, I mean, yeah, I just literally took a hose and washed some of the major chunks of dirt off of this thing. But as you can see, there's still a bit of dirt and stuff on here. Mostly this area down here that I was talking about by the motor. These fenders really need something done with them. But I parked it on the towel in here so I wouldn't ruin the floor as much. But let's go ahead and take this thing out to the garage, and we'll fire up the air compressor and get all the dirt blown out of everything on it. I think the batteries on this are probably cycled at this point, as in I can probably run them down fairly low and do a range test on it, and it shouldn't really cause a problem. So I'm going to try and do that here soon. Only issue being 6 miles an hour and 12 miles. I mean, I don't know what the math is on that. Very simple, but it's a lot more fun to use the Quantum 6000Z and go blasting around at like 9 miles an hour and run the batteries dead. So I'll have to find a trail on this thing. Maybe I'll go out with some other friends that also have normal speed chairs and we can do a range test on it. But that's the only thing is I'm like, oh, it's gonna take so long. But yeah, let's go out of the garage and get this thing cleaned up. Again, this is a brand new chair, and look how much movement we have when it stopped. You hear that clicking? That is loose parts. I do like the chair. I wish it could have been assembled at the same quality control standards that the first one was. I know it will get sorted out eventually, but I'm just going to keep using the thing. I'm not going to say I'm going to rail on it, but I am going to use it heavily and make sure we get all the problems shaken down. I do keep getting random errors on it. I got one yesterday for the main contactor. And when I was over at my friend's place, I figured that was the best place to be since there was going to be a bunch of people around in case I did get stuck and something did happen. But every time the chair stopped and threw an error, all I had to do was reboot it and then it was fine. I don't know if it's the uneven terrain
or this thing has sensors inside both of the rear caster wheels. I don't know if those are what's causing issues or if there's bad connections. If you look at this motor, you can see right here these little shiny parts, which that's indicative of, I don't know if it was taken apart or when it was put together or what exactly, but what I'm going to be doing to fix this ultimately once this is all said and done, assuming they don't do it, is removing the back half of this motor and
tightening up the brake assembly and making sure the bolts that hold the entire mechanism together are actually tight.
But since they only replaced one of the motors, and you're supposed to replace motors in a set, I don't care if they're brand new or not, it's about when they were manufactured. You want to get both of the motors replaced with as close to the same manufacture date as possible. Because quality control standards aside, like, when you're making electric motors, that's just how things are. If you get one from now and the exact same one from 8 months later, things are slightly different. So I think I'm going to be able to get them to replace both of the drive motors here. I don't know. Every time it throws an error, I just send it into them, and yeah. Again, I do like the chair. I am going to keep using it. I'm just going through all the motions at this point. I did get a response from the FDA finally, and they said they're looking into it. They've actually posted my complaint on their website, which is public, and they're going to get a hold of me within, well, they said within 30 to 60 days if they do want to actually come out and take a look at it. So until then, business as usual. I'm just going to keep using it. Try to make sure I'm not going to put myself in a situation where if it does have an error and get stuck, I'm not in danger, which means I'm not going to be crossing streets with it or using it like I normally would. But it did really well off-road, and I'm impressed. So all the incidental things will get taken care of eventually. I'm being patient. It's June now, by the way. It's been 1 year since we started this whole process. I can't believe it actually happened to me. Not like I'm immune from problems, but I just hear about the stories of people waiting, you know, 6, 8 months, a year, sometimes 2 or 3 years. And it boggles my mind that this continues to happen. The cat is out of the bag, though. The factory rep does know that I make videos now. hey, if you're watching, I don't know if the people at the DME are aware yet. The thing is, like, I want to go through this process just like everyone else and not try to get any, like, you know, special treatment, as it were. I just want this to be, I'm a normal customer, I'm going through the process, I'm trying to show everyone how this typically works. You know, if someone high profile, which I am not, but if someone that was super high profile went through, you can bet 100% for sure that things would be spot on right the first time and quick. But that's not the point here. anyways, I'm not sure what else to say at this point. Just a short little update on this thing. And yeah, we'll take it from there.